It is because I want us to have a consensus on a sustainable method of mining the minerals in our land. We cannot have one part of the political divide campaigning for Kalamse in the bush and the other waging an official fight against Kalamse in the open. We must demonstrate that we love our land and are capable of taking care of it ourselves. We do not need foreigners to campaign for the protection of Ghanaian land, our inheritance. We do not need special interest groups to campaign for the protection of Ghanaian soil, flora, and fauna. It is the land of our birth. It is the land we inhabit. It is the land that supports our lands, our lives, and livelihoods. It is the land we named Ghana at independence 64 years ago. And we, the Ghanaian people, must be its best protectors of partisan politics. We must, however, come to the understanding that small-scale mining and the requirement to do away with illegalities in that sector should be beyond partisan politics. Government has a major responsibility to this end, as we are accountable for the stewardship of this sector, as indeed we are of all other sectors of national life. I am determined to enforce the laws on illegal mining, no matter the subject, high or low. I will, however, not act on hearsay or mere allegations without more. I will not hesitate to act, though, where the evidence is hard before the police, and I will do so irrespective of the standing of the person or persons involved. That is the true meaning of equality before the law. I urge this colloquium to be bold and forthright in its deliberations. In other words, say it as it is. No subject or person should be above critique. Politicians, traditional authorities, policymakers, media, so-called influential people should all not be beyond your scrutiny.